so we're going to move on to our next test, which is going to be to perform a starter draw test. The starter draw on this engine is located right behind here. The batteries are located in this box, so we're going to hook up our machine to the batteries of the machine, the batteries of the backhoe, and get started. Now these batteries are covered by a few covers, so what we're actually going to use is a jump start terminal on the top, and there is a symbol here showing ground. This is where they would intend the negative to hook up for a charger or any jump starting, or in this case for a VAT 45. So we'll take our cables, make sure we have a good connection on each, and this will allow the machine to power up once again. For a starter draw test, we're going to be measuring the amperage that the engine uses to crank. Now this will vary based on the size of the engine, the compression, whether it's a worn out engine will actually crank much easier and lower amperage than a new, tight, good compression engine. So it's very difficult to find specs from the manufacturer. You will find specifications in our manual for the machine. Normally what we recommend for our heavy duty diesel engines is typically up to 125 amps per cylinder. So this is a four cylinder engine. So we would be looking for, you know, basically 500 amps, somewhere in that range. So our machine's fired up. We will use the scroll wheel to select our starter test. You'll notice that the batteries on this engine or this machine are already at 12.29. Typically we'd want to see 12.4 ideally, but this is pretty close. Notice what it says. First is to place the amps probe. We're measuring the current the starter is using, so we want this amps probe around, ideally, the positive battery cable going right to the starter. Remember, that arrow needs to be in the direction of current flow, so we want that arrow pointing from the battery to the starter. So we'll place that around here. Make sure it latches. Hopefully you can see that wire there on the starter solenoid. That's coming directly from the battery cable. It's going to be the thickest wire, of course. And next, it says to disable the ignition. This is an important step. When we do this test, we want the machine to crank. We want this backhoe to crank and not start. Now, there's a few ways you can do that. The manual goes over how to do it for gas engines. Typically, we're not dealing with gas engines where we can disconnect a coil or a fuel pump. And on some instances, there are sensors on the engine electronics or injection system you can unplug, but they will often throw code. So one of the most universal ways to disable that would be to hook up what we have here, which is a remote starter button. This can attach directly to the starter solenoid. You would put one lead on the S terminal. The other lead would attach to battery positive, or where that positive cable terminates. And when you push this button, that will activate the starter and cause that engine to crank. Now there are a few safety precautions, and we'll mention them before we get started, but let's get this attached to the S terminal and the back terminal. You want to make sure you have good secure connections so when the engine starts cranking, they don't fall off of there. Now, this tool can be very dangerous if not used properly. When we push this button, this engine will crank, and that's regardless of what position the engine's in, whether it's in gear, whether the key is on. So you always want to make sure that you're out of gear, and there we're in neutral. You want to make sure that you have the keys with you, that the machine is not powered on, so that it will not start. Remember, this will work for any machine that's going to require a key to be on for the engine to be running and would shut off with the key. Some older engines might have a manual shut off. That engine could still start, so you would want to make sure to find another way to disable that. So we're all set. You can notice that they ask us to press yes to continue. So we have the amp probe placed. Our amps is zeroed or negative one, which is good. We have the ignition disabled. We'll press yes. And now it says start cranking engine. Now it's going to wait to see us begin to crank. We don't want to crank more than 15 seconds. This is actually going to start a 10 seconds timer when we start cranking. So we will begin. You You want to make sure that you keep it cranking the full 10 seconds until the machine tells you to stop or until it freezes your readings. And you'll notice we have a few pieces of information. It tells us our average voltage was 10.35. Our amperage average was 452 amps. And our maximum, which was probably the initial when it started cranking, was at 479 amps. If you remember, I said that ballpark of basically 125 amps per cylinder would mean this would crank around 500 amps. It seems pretty close. We're just under this. This would seem to be a good test. It can be difficult to make judgments based on this. It might be helpful to have always a track record and know what it is when it's in good condition. If that starter had a short or excessive resistance cranking, we would see that amp reading much higher than this. And that's going to complete our starter test.